But at this point, I think they're just hoping that the driver will just come to his senses and pull over, which he might be doing now. So this is going to be a felony stop. It's going to be a big one because all those units are going to pull in behind him. As you see them lining up, stacking up there, they're going to have their guns drawn. And they're going to order the driver out. They're going to order him to throw the keys out, and that will be the first step. Oh, he's going to take off on him. So he let them get out of their vehicles. Oh, no, he's going to make a U-turn. So this isn't good. He's going to go back towards them. Oh, look at that. Okay, so they tried to maybe come in on him. And so now we're going to go back the opposite direction. He has an opportunity, I believe, to get on the freeway here. Let's see if that CHP was still there. Yep, he's there, and that's an off-ramp. So, okay, he's going to come to another stop here. Right. You never want to see a suspect do that. Now he's going to hit the gas again. So he's playing a little cat and mouse with those officers. Boy. Across, you got him, Anton. And out again. He's going to make a right-hand turn. Arlita. I do hear the LAPD talking about spike strips and trying to get it set up, so we'll see if they have something set up here or maybe elsewhere. But for now, the speed's, again, slow. Again, one more time. I think he was shouting back at the officers. He cracked the window a little bit. And here we go again. Yeah, showed his hands. Yep. All right, so we're northbound on Arlita. We have, it's going to be Osborne coming up in about a mile. And heavy traffic here. He's going to go into the double yellows. Let me come out wider and look at the intersection he's coming up on. Yeah, look at all that traffic ahead of him. So we'll see what he tries to do here if he goes the wrong direction on the road. And it looks like he's going to. Yes. Right, so that would have been in the south. Here's the northbound option, and he's going to do it. He's going to go north 5. You can hold here, Anton. So maybe we'll get another look here into the passenger seat. Yeah, is that a white dog? Yeah, there you go. Maybe. Yeah, no, well, we haven't been able to see in the back. It's pretty heavily tinted, and the two side, that slider, those slider doors have some sort of a screen or something over the windows. So difficult to see in the back, but definitely the dog in the front. The driver, and he is definitely going onto the 210 now, and we're going to make that transition turn to the east here as he goes under us. Yeah, I'm looking out that way, Sharon. He's got wide open lanes. We'll see if the driver tries to speed it up here, but the highest speed we've seen is 55 miles an hour from this driver. Exiting. Yeah, he's doing it again. He got off the freeway. Now he's pulling over. We'll see if he this time does give up, throw those keys out. But we've seen it three times before where he's done this, pulled over, waits for the officers to get out of their vehicles. They are on a felony stop with their guns drawn, and then he'll simply take off. It looks like he rolled down the window again, and there he goes. So that's his pattern. He decides to just wait for the officers to get out, and now it looks like he's going to get back on the freeway. Back on the 210 heading back towards the 5. No. And there are still 10 units in the pursuit, 11 units now that I counted. I'm just hearing that the CHP is assisting but not taking the pursuit, and they did have a successful spike strip as he went just north of the 14 freeway on the 5 freeway. So let's come in and see if we can see those tires going down. It looked like there might have been some smoke coming off the tires there a short time ago. Hard to tell. It's a little dark out here, but CHP is confirming that they had a successful spike strip on the vehicle, and they have units up ahead off of McBean. In case the driver gets off there, and they are going to allow this, the LAPD is going to stay in this pursuit, and they're going to make the felony stop once it comes to a stop. Yes, in fact, LAPD just asked for the CHP to take over the pursuit because they're so far out of pocket. Now, LAPD units will stay in pursuit, at least the lead vehicles and supervisor to make the arrest, but for now, the California Highway Patrol is in charge of this chase. And we'll see what they decide to do. If they try to do a pit maneuver, maybe they won't. But we have, as far as traffic, we're basically coming up to the Magic Mountain area. We're in Valencia, and we have the 126 highway coming up. But if it doesn't take that, it's going to be northbound 5 towards the Grapevine. Yeah, that's going to be a CHP officer that is getting ahead of the pursuit, maybe to help with traffic, maybe a spike strip. We'll see what happens. They haven't mentioned a spike strip in the last few minutes. We'll see, though, that officer is getting up ahead of the pursuit. And at this point, no traffic getting on the freeway. Here's a look at the 5 ahead of the pursuit. And there is some traffic there coming up, so that might be the reason for that officer to get up there to assist. From my picture, it looks like it's down and there's communication underway. They are quite a ways back, though. You see how far back they are, and that's using precaution because of the talk about her being armed. So at this point, communication underway. They want her to throw those keys out. We haven't seen that, at least from... She's got the dog in the hand. Oh no. Good to go. Good news.